Hello, Renas here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. Today we're going to take a look at the Azure Reports by Sparky Fox, the Paragus Cryopod by Maxime 7080, the Mini Solar Panels by Gopher, the Nano Medical Panels V2 by Sultan MRP, and the Small Wheel Bucket Excavator by Gina Whitney. I think that's how you pronounce that. I changed this from text panel to an LCD because too much text on screen. It was meant to be another mod, but I can't get it working properly. Well, it works properly, I just can't figure out how to configure it. So we'll do that one next week. But first, let's take a look at the horse. Whee! Yep. It's just a horse. And that's it. That consists of tongue. I think it's a control C. Yeah, it's a control C. So you can add various components to it in order to make it fly or drive or whatever you want. So yeah, you can make an interesting contraption with this thing. And as for its build cost, it is 20 steel plates and 50 canvas. So it's not expensive, quite cheap. It's even got its name on there, the Thunderclap. Which is what you're going to have to go search for in the menu if you want to find it. Notice how only the recolorable bits actually show up. And again, it might be the same problem with the previous mod, that Halloween pack, where the texture caused a problem. Best not, because it might bug out the video. You know, desyncing the audio and video again? Me. But yeah, that's not its default color. I made it blue. As you know, winner! How's their tail though? Oh well. So anyway, not really much else to say about a control seat. That's in the shape of a horse. So let's move on to the cryopod. Which is actually a pretty interesting design. It does have a conveyor port on the bottom, and it does come with its own flooring. Thus, if you have another mod that adds the same sort of flooring, it'll mesh in quite well. It's also got an LCD panel, which you can change. So you can change its colour. And if you got a programmable block set up, you can even have this tell you if it's occupied or not, its condition, and all that kind of stuff. Or whatever else the custom LCD mod can do. Well, script. Not really a mod. Although you can obviously see there's somebody in there. Ooh. Reflections. And there we go. Sweet. Anyway, that's what its build cost. It is 10 bulletproof glass, 40 interior plates, 30 computers, 3 medical components, 8 displays, 8 motors, and 20 construction components. So it's not that bad. It's a bit on the cheaper side. Well, the medical components are a pain in the ass to carry around. Because I think you can only carry 2 or 3 of those if you only have 400 litres of capacity. Which I had significantly more due to being creative. So yeah. Anyway. That's all there is to say about that, because it's just the cryopod. So, you know. But I do really like the details on this. A lot of work was clearly put into it. I wonder if that's actually a model or just a texture. Yeah, this whole grated thing. Probably just a texture with a bump map on it. Yeah. Yeah, it definitely looks like that. So anyway, why don't we move on to the solar panels? Now these solar panels are just one block and a slanted one. We'll get my words right. You see, it's just a solar panel in one space. And as you may realize, it looks like a squashed vanilla one. Which it is indeed a squashed vanilla. As the modmaker has admitted to. But oh well, Doesn't really matter. Still works. One thing I find amusing about this one, it just uses the panel from this. When I get to it. Never one. It just uses the vanilla panel as the backing and then it just puts the squish solar panel on top of that. It is kind of handy really, because it helps you mesh it into your armor a bit better as well, if you're using these panels as your armor. As for their power production, woo-wee! There we go. The Mini has a max output of 130 kilowatts, while the Sloped has the same. But what about a Vanilla? How does it compare? Well, so yeah, it's automatically put into the same grouping as the Vanilla stuff, which makes it very handy. Yeah, go to Solar. Compared to Vanilla. Yeah. It's only 30 kilowatts weaker than Vanilla. So, you're kind of better off having 8 of these rather than one of those. Because you put 8 of those in the space of one of those. As for build cost, it's a 2 bulletproof glass, 2 construction components, 16 solar cells, 2 computers, 6 girders, 5 construction components, well, 7 construction components overall, as well as 2 steel plates. It has half the amount of solar cells. So it should really be 50% power output compared to that. It would still be more efficient to have a bunch of those than that. But yeah. Oh well. And this one has more steel plates. You know, mainly for the piece in the pack. And that uses 6 there. That only puts up to 4. Should really put it to 8. Oh well. No matter. Yeah, they're kind of the same apart from the increase in the steel plates. Very helpful to have solar panels in places where you normally can't. I do believe they are large grid only. Yeah, they are large grid only. Bit of a shame, but still, there are some larger builds that don't have a lot of space for the vanilla solar panel, so having these ones will be quite useful. Thus, you'll be able to stick them everywhere. Well, on to the next one. There's not really much else to show about those. Just solar panels. Right here is the medical thing. The Nano Medical Panel V2. And bunk. This one heals you. One thing it also says in the title is that it's silent and there's no respawn point available on this one. So yeah, you can't respawn on it. Which is logical, because it's tiny. Despite the fact it's still got the spawn name here, but it won't appear in the respawn list. Thus you can stick some of these about on your small ships, thus able to heal up while you're on the go. So say you have some sort of rover like this bugger, you just stick it on. Thus able to heal up, despite the fact this thing already has this. Yeet. Survival kit. As for its build cost, it is... Ooh, that's expensive. Okay, not really. It's a 10 interior plates, 20 construction components, 5 small steel tubes, 1 large steel tube, 2 displays, 5 computers, and 1 medical component. So yeah. Wait, does this thing have a... what do you call it? Conveyor? Quite far away. Oh yeah, it's got a conveyor, so you can use it to restore your oxygen and hydrogen. That's if your ship has enough to spare. Need a bunk. It would actually be quite useful to be on the go. Because you can create a small ship. One that's like 3x3x3 or something like that. Something that can follow you through doors and around a ship and contains hydrogen and oxygen, or just one of them, in order to refill your tank so you can stay on longer expeditions. That could be quite useful. So say you find an abandoned ship, it gives you more time to explore. Yeah, that's one way to do it. Or you can have it to heal you while you're in combat. Yeah. There's some useful, well, helpful uses for it. What's going with the shadows there? Looks a bit weird. What's happening upright, so I don't think it's anything to do with the mod. Anyway, now, let's move on to this drill. We've already done a larger version of this, I believe. Yeah, the small wheel bucket excavator. By Pino Whitney. Yeah, we've already done a larger version of this, not sure it's by the same person. But you see, it's just a wheel that spins in order to grind things up. As you can see. Wow. That's pretty damn fast. Would you agree? So I believe it's dig areas the same as a vanilla drill. It's just a different style you can use. As it's got small conveyors on either side and two on the back. Yes, you can see. Oh, the bottom was up there. That's to be expected, really. It's not really that big. As for its build cost, it is 32 steel plates, 30 construction components, 4 large steel tubes, 1 motor, and 1 computer. So it's not really that bad. Be helpful in what it does. And as I've said earlier, it just gives you a different style of drill to put onto your vehicle. Thus, you can make a land excavator. Yeah, could be useful. I guess you put this like on a mechanical arm and stuff as well. All sorts of interesting things you can do with it, depending on how creative you want to be. Or you can just be lazy and shove it in front of a vehicle like this and just drive through a wall. Although I'm not sure how well it'll go through a wall. Depends on how high up you put it. So anyway, I guess that's everything. There was meant to be another mod, as you tell by the two icons there. I can't get it working. Not properly anyway. I'll have links to all 5 mods in the description below. I don't know if I feel like I'm missing something. Oh yeah, they can all be recolored and retextured. I just forgot to do it beforehand. I'm not sure how well this changes. Let's give this one a quick check. This right at the end, we may as well. And oh yeah, that's definitely altered the audio video sync. It's a little bit of the lag there. Not too bad. Ooh, what about you? What if I change texture for you? Makes you blue. Yeah. Nothing. I'll make you blue neon. I never actually got that neon texture to apply, to be honest. There we go. Oh, well, let me change it. Put the rest on there. Kinda worked. What about you? Oh, the bottom bit changes. The panel will change as well. That helps it blend in more as well. Nice. Too bad about the edge though. Is that normal? Oh yeah, that's normal. Cool. So yeah, there'll be links for all 5 mods down in the description below. And I hope you all enjoyed this video. Yeah? Please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.